Okay, students, so we will start our exercise 1.1. So before I start this one, what are the things we have studied in your first part is, what is set, we have studied this, then how it is represented, okay. Next, we have studied about the symbol belongs to and not belongs to, right. For if element, for example, I said, right, A, B, C, suppose it is an element of set A, denoted by A. Then we can write, if A is element of this one, we can write A belongs to A. Suppose I say E, whether it is there or not in the set, no, right? So we used to write A does not belong. Does not belong, how we'll write? Like this. First use the symbol belongs and then cross it. It means E does not belongs to A. You can see E is, if I write this symbol, we will understand that E is not there in the set A. You can say there is no E. Okay, so these are the symbols we use. And in representation, two ways are there, right? Roster form and set builder form. In roster form, what we used to do, we used to list all the elements. Okay, in your collection, whatever elements are there, we used to list that one. And in set builder form, what we used to do, we don't list element, we used to write one property. And that property you have to write in such a way that we must be able to list element from your property. Whatever property you have written, from there I must be able to figure out what are the elements here. Okay, you have to write down the property in that way. So let's see in the exercise what are all this meaning. We will understand in the exercise also. Okay, so first question of your exercise 1.1, I will just show you the question here. So what it says, you can open up your textbook, okay, and you can see the question. So what it says, the collection of all months of a year beginning with the letter. So basically, what is the question? Which of the followings are set? They are asking you and justify your answer. So whether this statement which is given here, this are set or not, you have to mention. Now set, what was the definition? It must be well defined and distinct. Okay, so those will be called as set. So see here, in this case, the collection of all the months of a year beginning with the letter J. So beginning with the letter J, can you collect set? Of course, yes. January, June, July. So this 3 months is the only one which starts with letter J, right? So if every person try to collect, everyone will get this collection only, same collection. So obviously this will be a set. So how we will write down this one? So the collection of all the months, okay, of a year beginning with the letter J is well defined. Okay, as the collection will not vary, means it will not change from person to person, will not vary from person to person. Okay, so I hope you have understood this statement which is given. It is well defined, means you can easily say what are the collection here. Okay, and the collection for each person will be same. Okay, that's why it is well defined. So this will be a set. So that's why we have written the collection of all months beginning with the is well defined, as the collection with all will not vary from person to person, thus it is a set. You can write, thus it is a set. Okay, same way other question also you have to write down statement. I hope you have understood how to write down, right? So yes, I will just discuss the collection of 10 most talented writer of India. So let me write number 2 also. So number 2, how you will write? Now this time what you have to collect? You have to collect 10 most talented writer of India. Now 10 most talented writer will change person to person, means when you will try to write down the collection here, write down the set, each person may have different collection. So this kind of collection is not set in maths. In reality you can say that one is set, right, in real life, but here in maths what we discuss is it should be well defined. So this talented writer word itself is not well defined, because at what level you will say a person is talented, right? So this view will change person to person. That's why it is not a set. So how we will write? The collection of 10 most talented writers of India is not well defined. So how you'll write? Ask the collection here will ask the collection will vary from person to person. Okay, person to person. So you know that in this case what will happen, each and every person will have different kind of collection, because for different person talented writer may be different. So this word talented writer is not well defined. Okay, we cannot determine at what level actually a person is considered to be talented. So for different person the talented writer will be different. Okay, I hope you have understood. So number three, a team of 11 best cricket batsmen. Again same, this will not be a set. The collection of all boys in your class will be a set, right? Because collection of all boys in your class will be same for all the person. Every person, if they try to write down the collection, every person will write down the whatever number of boys are there, their list they will give, right? So obviously it is well defined. So it is a collection. It is a set. Okay. So the collection of all natural number less than 100, that is also set. Less than 100, all natural number you can list or not. Yes, 1 to 99. So the collection of all Nobel writer by the Nobel written by the writer Munshi Premchand. So Munshi Premchand, whatever Nobel he have written, can you find out the list or not? Yes, you can easily find out, and every person will have same collection here also. So Munshi Premchand, whatever Nobel he have written, if you try to find out, and if you find out all the Nobels, then every person will have same collection for sure, right? So this is a set. Okay, well defined. The collection of all even integers, obviously this is also a set. Collection of all even integer you can list or not? Obviously it will be infinite, you may not be able to end up, but you can list all the even integer. Okay, so it is well defined. So if you can list the element in the set, all element, then it will be a set. Okay, next question. Number 8, the collection of question in this chapter. So in this chapter means, suppose in this set chapter, collection of all collection of questions in this chapter. So if I ask you, collect questions of this chapter, you can collect or not? Obviously you can list this questions, all these questions in your set, right? So this will be a well-defined set, obviously. Okay, it's because you can list, because every student, if they listed all the question which they will list, will be same for person to person. Okay, so a collection of number 9, a collection of most dangerous animals of the world. Now this is also not well defined. Why? Because person to person dangerous animals will be different. Some people's feared with spider also, right? Some fear with different kind of animals. So you cannot list this also. Means person can list, but person to person it will change. So this in maths it is not set. Okay, in reality it will be set. Obviously a different person will have collection. If I ask you, what are the animals you afraid of? So obviously you will make one list, right? Whatever is the animal, you will write down that one. So it will become a set. But that in maths it is not set. Why? Because in maths, person to person the collection must not change. Okay, every person must have same kind of collection. So if you make this kind of collection, obviously every person will have different collection. So that's why it is not a set. So it is not well defined here. Okay, because this dangerous word, you know that it does not have that minimum level through which you can consider it to be dangerous. Okay, so number 2, so these things you write down the statement. Okay, if you have any doubts, ask me in the comment section. Number 2, let A is equal to this. So they have given a set. Can you see A is equal to, inside curly bracket, elements are given. What are the elements here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So these are the elements of set A. Now they are asking insert I hope you can see. Insert the appropriate symbol. So you have to insert one symbol. Can you see they have given dot dot dot? You have to put symbol here. Which symbol it will satisfy, you have to put that. Okay, so appropriate symbol, this symbol stands for belongs to or not belongs to in the blank. So first question, 5-A. So what symbol you will put here? Number 2. So your number 2, what they have given? They have given a set. What are the elements here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Till 6 you have, right? So these are the elements. Now first question is, so you have to insert belongs or does not belong symbol, right? This, out of these two, one symbol you have to put. So see here, they have asked you, first one is 5-A. Now 5 belongs to A or does not belong to. So I told you, right, belongs to means this must be element of A. So 5, it's there inside A or not? Yes, it is there, so it belongs to. Okay, very simple, right? Number 2, 8-A. So 8, is it there inside A? Obviously no, so does not belong. Number 3, obviously in exam they will not ask this kind of question. This we are going to apply in the upcoming exercise and all. Okay, so you try to understand all, since this is new for you. So simple question they have given here. Okay, so don't expect this kind of question in exam. So number 3, 0-A they have given. So 0, it is there? No, does not belong. 4-A. 4, is it there? Yes, so belongs to A, means it is. And when I write, oh sorry, when I write this symbol like this, 4 belongs to A, it means 4 is element of A. Okay, means when you write set, 4 will be there in the set. Okay, so try to understand this symbol also properly. So rest you try. Okay, 10, number 6 they have given, 10-A. 10-A. So 10, is it there in the set? No, so does not belong. Okay, simple question. So let's move to question number 3. So question number 3, what it says. So I hope you have opened up your textbook, right? So see from there, okay, if you have any problem here. So you can see question number 3, what it says. Write the following sets in roster form. In roster form means you have to list the element. In roster form, what we used to do? In roster form, we used to list all the elements. Okay, so you have to write the sets in roster form in this question. So, let's see what they have given. First one, A is equal to X. Okay, means element of A is X. Now, what is X? X is an integer. So, you know what is integer, right? X is an integer. Now, what kind of integer? Restriction is given. X can be less than 7 and greater than equal to minus 3. Okay, so how you will write down in roster form? So see question number 3-1. So they have given you A is equal to set whose element is X. Now what is X? This is in set builder form they have given. Okay, can you see they have given property here? So with the help of this, I have to write in roster form. Roster form means I have to list the element. What will be the element we have to write down? Oh. Okay, so X is the element. Now what is X? X is an integer, they have said. Is an integer. So you know integer, right? 0, 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2. All of you know this. Right? So till infinite will go on your left also, on your right also. Okay? Integer. Such that restriction is given. X, what you can take? Only those which are less than 7. Greater than equal to minus 3. You know this symbol, right? X can be greater than minus 3 and equal to minus 3. Okay, so see how I will write down in roster form. A has element X. What is X? X is an integer. So if I stop here, if I don't see this one, then what will be the element? All element like this. A is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It will go on like this. Then minus 1, minus 2. 0, 1, 2. Do go on like this on your left. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. It will go on your left like this. On your right also. It will go on. It will never end. If they don't mention this portion. Now they have mentioned this portion, right? What is this? X should be less than 7. This is restriction, okay? You cannot take all integers. When you have seen x is an integer, don't write all integer. You have to see the restriction also. X should be less than 7 and greater than equal to minus 3. X can be greater than or equal to minus 3. So minus 3 will be there, okay? And greater than minus 3 means minus 2, greater than minus 2. Oh, minus 3, what is the integer? Minus 2, right? Greater than this, minus 1. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Less than 7. 7 also will not be there. So I hope you can understand. X can be less than 7 and greater than equal to minus 3. So first equal to minus 3 I have written. And greater than, X can be greater than minus 3 also, right? And X is an integer, remember. Don't take the decimal numbers. So minus 3, next integer will be minus 2, minus 1. Till what you can take, x will be less than 7. Less than 7 means what is the integer less than 7? 6. So till 6, whatever integers are there, all I will do. So you can see in this sets, all elements are integer as well as less than 7. All elements are less than 7, right? And all elements are greater than minus 3 as well as equal to minus 3, you can see. Okay, I hope it is clear a little bit. Let's move to next question number 2. Number 2, what they have said, b is equal to, let me write down here, okay, x. Again, it is an element x. X, what it is? X is a natural number. X is a natural number less than 6. Actually, the topic is very simple, okay. So, don't worry. Since it is for the first time, you might think that what kind of topic it is. Now this has lots of application in probability calculus. Many things are there, okay? In many chapters you will use this concept. So try to understand carefully. This is the base for your relation and function as well as for your trigonometry also, okay? When you will study about set well, you will understand relation and function. And relation and function, when you will study understand, then only you can understand trigonometry and moreover probability also, okay? So you need to concentrate well here. If you have any doubt, clear it, okay? Don't keep any kind of doubts. So in this case, again I have to write in roster form, right? B is a set where I have to list all the elements. Now what are the elements here? They have given in set builder. You can see in this part, they have not given you what are the elements here. They have just simply given you one property. What is the property? They have said B is X, means X is the element of B. Now X is variable, right? X can be anything. Now what is X? X is a natural number. Now if I stop here, if I don't see this portion, what will be the element? All natural number I will write, right? Now they have given restriction, you can see. X is a natural number less than 6. So less than 6, what are the natural number? 1. Natural number starts with 1, right? 2, 3, 4 and 5. Less than 6 they have said. So this will be the element. You can see B is an element which is natural number and less than 6. B is an element. What is this element? X is a natural number less than 6. So you can see all the elements. So just by looking at this property, I am able to write down the element of this set. I can list the element. So that's why this is called set builder form. They have given you the property. They have not given what are the elements here. They didn't list it. I mean, okay. They have given the property and we can list the element from this property. So this is called your set builder form. This is your roster form, okay, or tabular form also they used to say. Okay, so number 3, X is 2 digit natural number such that the sum of its digit is 8. Okay, number 3, what it says, C is a set where element is x. Now what is x? X is a two digit number such that, again restriction, some restriction, such that the sum of its digit is 8. Okay, so can you list the element here? See carefully. So I hope you have noticed this. When I write set, what bracket I'm using? Curly bracket here. Okay, so be careful. When you write set, always use curly bracket. So C is a set whose element is X. What is X? X is a two digit number. So if I stop here, don't see the restriction. Two digit number, what it is? You know, two digit number starts from 10, 11, it will go on till 99. Till 99, you will have all the two digit number. Now this all element I cannot write here because they have given. You have to write down those two digit numbers such that the sum of its digit is 8. So sum must be 8. So you can see 1 plus 0 is how much? 1, it's not 8. So this cannot be the element here. Okay, I hope you can understand. So what will be the first element here? 1, 7, 17 will be the first two digit element, right? You can see 1 plus 7, 8. Next will be 2, it should be 8, right? 26. Next will be which one? It's 26. Then 27, obviously no, it will be greater. 28, 29, no, 30, no, 31. In this way you find out. 35, 44, right? In this way you find out sum must be 8. You can see I have written those two digit whose sum is 8. So 44 to 50 obviously will not come now. 50 to 60, one two digit number will be there whose sum will be 8. So what it will be? 5, 3. Next 6, 2. 62. Can you see when I write element I used to separate it by comma? Always remember your elements must be separated by comma. If you don't put in set, it is very important. Everything you have to mention carefully. If you don't put even comma, your marks will be deducted in exam, remember. And if you by mistake, if you use other bracket instead of curly bracket, your full marks will be deducted here, because these are very important symbols which you need to use carefully. Okay, 62. Next will be 71. Next will be 80, right? Then any other number? These are the only two digit number whose sum will be 8. Okay, if you have any other number you can list that. Okay, so you can see I have written those two digit numbers whose sum is 8. So by the property I am able to write down the elements. I can list the element. That's why this is a set, and it is in set builder form, and this is in roster form. I hope it is getting more clear now, right? So next is question number 4. I'm not going to write down the question here, okay? You just see. I hope you have textbook, all of you, right? So you see from your textbook, okay? So number 4, what it says? D. Set D you have to write down in roster form, okay? What is D element is X. What is X? X is a prime number. Now you know what is prime number? Those numbers are said to be prime number who have exactly how many factors? Two factor it must, okay? Now 1 is not a prime number. Why? 1 has only one factor. You know what is the factor? Only one, right? There is no other factor. So that's why 1 is not a prime. The first prime number is 2. After that, 3. Then 5. So it will go on. So if I stop here, X is a prime number. If I stop there, then the element will be 2, 3, 5, 7. In this way, it will go on. All the elements, right? So it will be infinite in this way. Now see the restriction they have given. Which is divisor of 60? So you have to write down those prime number which are divisor of 60. Now you know what is divisor, right? When you divide some number, this is called dividend. Here whatever you will get quotient, this is your divisor. By whatever number you are dividing this, that is called your divisor. So you have to write down the set of divisor here, right? D is equal to X. X is a prime number which is divisor of 60. Okay, division of 60, what are the prime numbers? Now first prime number I said it was 2, right? So 2, is it division of 60? Yes, you can see it will divide easily, right? 2 times 30 are 60. 2 is divisor, so 2 will be the first element here. Next, 3. 3 is the prime number. Now 3 is divisor or not? Yes, divisor of 60, 3 times 20 are 60. 3 is divisor. Next, 5. 5 is divisor. Yes, 5 also will divide this, right? 5 times 1 are 5. 1 goes here, 2. So 12. So you will get 5 also divisor of 60. So 5 also will be the element. Next, after this 7. Now 7 will not divide this. Okay, divisor means now remainder must be 0. Those number only. Don't take point and all. Okay, 7 is not divisor of 60. Okay. You have to find those divisor which are exactly divisible. Okay, that's what the meaning here in the question. Now don't predict that like 760 you will take. I can divide this, I know, but your remainder will be some value. Means the if you want to make this one zero, remainder zero, then it will come, quotient will come in terms of decimal. Those numbers you cannot take decimal one. It should be perfect numbers. Okay, perfect real numbers. Perfect real numbers, that is not the correct word. I can say whole number it should be. Okay, so 7 will not divide 60 exactly, right? So 7 cannot be the element here. Next prime number, in this way you find out. So next will be, let's take 11. Now 11 also will not divide, 13 also will not divide, after that 17 also will not divide. In this way you find out. Now till what number you will find? Infinite, obviously. No, this 60 will get divided by maximum what number? Obviously half of this, 30. More than that if you take, no number will be there which can divide this. For example, I will take 6. 6 is divided by what number? 2, 3. 3 is half of 6, 6, right? Now more than 3 if you take, means half of a number if you take more than that, then that number will never divide this. Okay, so more than half, if you take any number, those numbers will not divide for sure. You can check this one with any number. So after 30, no need to check any numbers. Till 30 you check what are the prime numbers which will divide 60. Okay, so 17 will not divide. Next prime number is 19, will not divide. Next will be 23, will not divide. Next will be 30. 29. 29 also will not divide. So 30. 30 will divide, right? 30 times 260. So 30 also will be, sorry, 30 is not a prime number again. 29, right? So this will be your set. 30 is not a prime number. 29, after that what will come? 31. 31 will not divide. And after that, whatever prime number you take, I say, right, half of this is 30. More than that, whatever number you will take, exactly it will never divide this. Okay, except the number itself, 60. Okay, so more than 29, obviously 31, this will come now, prime number. So those prime numbers obviously will not divide 60. So this is the only element of this set, 2, 3 and 5. Okay, if I missed out something, you try to check out. Explanation, I have already given the meaning. Okay, so I may made mistake somewhere. Okay. So some prime numbers I may missed out also. So in this way you check out. Okay, so explanation I'm giving you. So if I make any mistake, so see that. Number 5. Now in number 5 what they have said? E is a set. X is a month of year not having 31 days. So not having 31 days, you can list, right? What are the months that is not having 31 days? So you just list that one. Okay, number 6, the set of all letters in the what? Wait, which one I have seen just now? Sorry, 5 is the set of all letters in the word trigonometry. Sorry, this one is different question I have seen. I think I have seen in question number 5. It's 3, right? 3, 5. The set of all letters in the word trigonometry. The set of all letters in the word trigonometry. Set of all letters, can you write down in the word trigonometry? So what are the letters? T, R, separated, that's it. Trigonometry. So these are the set. You can see this is a set where the elements are what? Letters of trigonometry. All the letters I have written of trigonometry. So this is how we write set. Okay. So simple question, right? So rest of the question from this, that is one question only left, you write yourself. Okay. Number four, write the following set in set builder form. Now this you have to write in set builder form. So first question I will show you. Okay, here one mistake they have done in question. Okay, this should not be open bracket like this. It should be curly bracket. By mistake they have put this. Okay, so you don't make mistake, don't write open bracket. It should be curly bracket here. Okay, so number one, what are the elements? 3, 6, 9, 12. So you have to write down this one in set builder form. So how you will write down in set builder? Let me name this one first. A is equal to this. You can name it always. Okay, A is equal to this set. Now I want to write this one in set builder form. Set builder form, how I will write? I will mention one property. A is equal to x. Elements are x. And what are x? 3, 6, 9, 12. You know that, right? So how you will mention one property such that with this property you must be able to get this? How you will write? So if you see well, this numbers, first number is 3, second 6, 9 and then 12. So you will see these are what? Multiple of 3, right? 3 into 1, 3 into 2, 3 into 3, 3 into 4. Can you see? So this is the property, right? Let me write down like that only. X is equal to, I am not going to list element here. I will simply write property. Any property you can write through which you can get this. So see how I'll write. 3 into n I will write. Now what is n? This can be what? Only 1, 2, 3, 4. Right? I hope you can understand. 3 into 1, 3. 3 into 2, 6. 3 into 3, 9. 3 into 4, 12. Now more than that you cannot take this. So n I can take 1 to 10. So what I will write? 1 to 4, sorry. N belongs to natural number I will write. Then again comma you give. N is less than 5. I hope you can understand. From this you can see I have mentioned the property like this. X is equal to what? 3n. Now n is what I have mentioned. See, n if I leave it like this, and n belongs to natural number, if I leave it like this, 3 into 1 you will take, 3 into 2, 3 into 3, 3 into 4, it will keep on moving like this. So you have to give one restriction. You know from here, you know that n I have to take till 4 only. 3 into 1, 3 into 2, 3 into 3, 3 into 4. Right? So n you just mentioned n less than 5, and I have already mentioned that n is natural number, so what you will take? So if you don't have this one, from this also you can write down the set. Okay, so this is not the only one, other way also you can write down. Since the time is too much, I will explain all this in the next class. Okay,